So as we mentioned before we went on the short break, we wanted to talk a little more about some of the services that your company, which is Trustway Senior Concierge Services, what are some of the services that your company offer to senior citizens?
So we divide the work in three main aspects. One would be the accessibility and mobility, which what I mentioned before, it's what we're concentrating more now. I'll go a little bit more in detail. Then we do the concierge, which is running errands, all that basically errands include. And then there's the relocation, which is when the person cannot live anymore in their big houses that they're living for 20, 30, even up to 50 years. We have a case that the people were living there for 50 years and they need to make their life easier and either go to a smaller place or they need to relocate either to go to an assisted living, a senior community. It doesn't need to be an assisted living. It can be a senior community where they will feel better, more attent. So we coordinate the selling of the property, and then we coordinate if they need to do donations or if they need to do moving, they want to send their things either to the new place or the piano to the grandchildren. And we do that part. And we also coordinate within that part, we coordinate like a handyman. So when they leave the house, and if we want to sell the house, instead of the house not looking well, we come, we paint the house so it looks good, the value of the house goes up, and we take care of that. So we, again, it's like a holistic point of view. It's don't worry, move, you have quite a lot of things. And we take care of the selling, of the cleaning, of the donations, of the moving. So the transition, it's nice and smooth, okay? So that's the last service. And when we go to the concierge, it relates if they need to go to a medical doctor, we accompany them. Again, the children, it's upstate New York, let's give that as an example, or even living in another country, and they don't want the parents to go by themselves. We accompany them and, you know, understand what is it that the doctor talks about. Sometimes the elderly person, you know, it's overwhelming or doesn't understand well. So what we do is we make sure we take them to the doctor and put them back in their houses, or if they need to go to a market, to a library, to do some kind of errand, we can take them. We, by the way, have a license, which is a non-medical homemaker companion, which is given by the healthcare association here in Florida. It's called the Healthcare Administration Division of Health Quality and Assurance. That means that we are background check level 2, which is like, what I want to tell you in a few words, it's we are background check. We're not just anybody. You can feel safe with us because all of the people are top of the line and check. You're not just sending your parents to do things with just anybody. It took us quite a lot of time to take this license, but we want everything to be correct. Working with the elderly community is very sensitive, and we want to make everything the correct way, in the good way, and that you, the children or the family member, feel at ease working with us.
So out of the three things, I did not get the first one.
So the first one is the mobility and accessibility. So that's where we go to the houses and we do the assessment of the house. We have, so maybe let me tell you a little bit, like a, let's put it up, pitch elevator explanation. So what the company does is a comprehensive home safety assessment to enable the older adults to stay safe in their homes. So we work with a 240 assessment questionnaire, and we walk all around the house, and after, you know, to for the fall prevention and accessibility, and there is, and if there have to have modifications that can impact the life of the elderly, we take care of that on giving them a report saying, you know, you should put more light here, you should take that rug out of there, you should put a grab bar in the bathroom, you should put extra light in several places, motion lights. So we give a report, and the family member or the elderly person decides what is it that they want to do. They can either do it by themselves, or we can have, we have vetted companies. Actually, the both that I work are nationwide, not only here in Florida, they are all over the states. They understand what is it that when they have to put a grab bar, at what height, depending on the person who's going to use it. So they understand better, so they can be there better, you know, live there more confident and safe better. One number that I want to give you, it's the AARP, which for the ones that don't know, it's the American Association of Retired Persons. It's a big, big association here in the United States. So they say that almost 90% of the older population wants to stay home and live at home. But guess what? Only 85%, I mean, not even 85% have done things to accommodate their houses to live independently, safely in their houses. So that's where we come in. So again, let me give you the number. Almost 90% of the elderly population want to stay home, or how they call it here, age in place. And maybe 15% of those people have done accommodations to live there. So there's a big potential for not only for me, but for everybody that offers to make the home safer, to work for them to be there safe and independent. This year, $50 billion were spent on medical-related falls. $50 billion is a lot of money that could save if they just done a couple of things like moving a rug, putting extra light, putting a grab bar. And not only, it's again, it's not the economic impact, which is $50 billion, it's a amazing, a too big of a number, but it's also the part of the elderly person. You know, you have to stay home, you cannot move, you end up being depressed, you end up, because of not moving, getting worse, worse and worse, and then it can happen the worst. I don't want to say the word, but you know, it's being proactive. So my message here in this program is, please be proactive. You can go online. There's many things that you, many resources, even through AARP, you say home safety assessments. You don't have to hire me. Please do it by yourself. Go online and see the simple things that you can do. Simple things can change lives.